it's 500 posts, because this is a section where there will still be people at, because there will be a lot of riots. Same goes for the IPv6. And now on to Daniel Massis with the Astro headquarters.
Thank you. Now, this topology is almost similar as the employee's office topology. But we've added more things. We have a WLAN controller, and this is just to control all wireless activities that go on throughout the park and HQs. We also have a DMZ, and inside that DMZ, we'll have an IDS and an IPS device, and we'll also have proxy servers and web servers. So people all around the world can access your website to buy merchandises, contact customer service, or even purchase a ticket online. And if the DMZ does get hacked, it wouldn't matter, because the internal network wouldn't be compromised. And we also have data center, but I'll talk about that later. This is the wireless floor plan. We are running Cat 6 cable throughout all floors, and also fiber connections through every IDM in each floor. This is the wireless floor plans. We only have 2 APs in each floor, distributing 802.11 ACs, and now this is the second floor. The second floor is where the conference room is going to be. This is where the admins are going to be, the CEOs, so they can execute their ideas and plan their ideas. And now, how I mentioned, there's only 2 APs in each floor, but this time the channels switch because we don't want channel overlapping. And if you look into our portfolio in section 7 floor plans, we have floors 3 to 6, so you can take a look at that. And now the data center. The data center, we're implementing SAN servers for more storage. We have first line of defenses, the IDS and the IPS on both switches. And we have the standard protocols, HTTP, FTP, DNS, name it. And this is also, and also for IPv6, just for future references. And now, here's Brian with the WAN topology.
Thank you, Daniel. Now, right here we have our WAN topology. We have the two ISP, Spectrum, and AT&T. Now, as mentioned before, since the HQ of Astroworld and Astroworld on the proximity isn't that far, we'll be running underground fiber. We also have a backup data center, but we're not going to be disclosing the location of the data center for security reasons. And now we have the same thing for IPv6. Now we'll be explaining the equipment. Now, as you can see right there, there's a bunch of Cisco devices. You may ask why. Cisco is one of the leading brands when it comes to networking. And when we look at the specifications, it just seems like a perfect fit for Astroworld. Now, if you want to see more information on the specifications of these equipment, you can check our portfolio. Now, here we have the RFID scanners. As Carlos mentioned before, we will be implementing the RFID scanners. When we looked at the specifications, we just saw everything, all the upsides that they had. We just decided this is the way to go. This is what we have to implement for Astroworld. And now we're going to be talking about the equipment cost analysis. With all equipment, it's going to be roughly, the cost will be roughly $5.9 million. Now here we have the service network cost analysis. Now depending on the item, consultation fees, etc., there will be a different type of unit pay. It could be monthly, one time, hourly, etc. Now the total upfront cost will be roughly $6.1 million. And now to Daniel Massis with the project timeline.
Now this is our project timeline. We already met with you beginning of this month, and this is our network proposal to you today. If confirmed, we will order the equipment, we'll contact both ISPs, Spectrum and AT&T. We'll configure the equipment, we'll install the cables, and after we are done, we will test to see if it's ready for public use late November. And now this is our pros and cons. We do have a lot of pros, but what's more important are the cons. It is expensive. Why? Because we are running fiber cables throughout every IDF and underground fiber link in each location. We also have redundancy, and the equipments are the best of the best. And another con is that your technicians will have to work in a loud environment due to the fact that Astroworld is a theme park. And now, BCD Enterprises would like to give a special thanks to
Aranya Mir and Noe Massis. Those were our mentors. You know, without them, this would have never been possible.
Mr. Vernon for helping us out throughout these 4 years in high school.
And our parents, and to you, the judges, because you took time off your busy schedules and looked at our proposals.
We would like to yield our time to the judges for any further questions.
So you guys say that this is looking at your floor plans, for a lot of the outdoor venues, you have your IDFs How do you physically secure those IDFs?
Okay, good question. We're gonna have IDFs in each building, but we're gonna have man traps so that it's just admins. They could put their fingerprint or password. Yeah, just basically match up. We'll have man traps just for security reasons. But it's not connected to our internal network, so our internal network won't be compromised.
Billy, a follow-up question: would any secure information fall into the hands of a hacker if they were to get information from those servers?
No, because it is a DMZ and it's not connected to our internal network.
What was one or two of your greatest challenges that you had to overcome doing the project?
Can you repeat the question?
What was one or two of your greatest challenges that you guys had to work through when putting together the project?
So on my end, finding the equipment was pretty difficult because we really did want to make sure that radio frequency technology would be able to be possible in Astroworld, because we do want to make this a reality, at least in some way or another. And with the implementation of radio frequency technology, we would know that guests would have a great time just with a simple wristband, like I was previously mentioning earlier. Another difficulty of this itself was making sure the proper placement of the access points and the physical security. As Dan was mentioning earlier, there is a man trap for the lost and found, but putting the physical security would be difficult because we wanted to make sure that involving that aspect, no one would still be able to get to that area specifically. So we would put it, for example, on our wire floor plans there. The IDS would be on the corner of the section. I mean, a corner of the food court and stuff like that.
For me, the greatest challenge is working with a team, because we have to collaborate with each other. We have to have the same ideas for this theme park. And yeah, that's basically it.
Now on my end, one of my challenges was time management. I tend to procrastinate a lot, so with this project, it taught me that you can't do things for the last minute.